Okay, in this video, I'm going to do my best to explain the sewing tools in CLO. If you are new to this, it might be a little bit of a learning curve, but I'm going to try to break it down as best as I can. So before you start sewing, you do need to understand how garments are constructed. So you do need to know how to how you would actually sew this right at a sewing machine. So that's really helpful. So if you see this pattern, you really need to know that this shoulder seam would get sewn to this shoulder seam, right? You need to know that the front side seam on the bodice gets sewn to the back. You would need to know that this arm piece, this long part of the arm, the underarm gets sewn to the other side, which makes like a tube. You would need to know that part of the little bell curve gets sewn to the front armhole and the other part gets sewn to the back. You would need to know that the ribbing trim gets sewn to the front and the back. So you definitely need to know how to construct garments. That's why I think taking a sewing class is so important. But okay, so start with that and maybe like jot it down to yourself, like what gets sewn to what, so you have some notes to refer to. In CLO, they have, I'm just gonna say, they have two sewing tools to start with. They have this one right here. It's called the segment sewing tool. Segment sewing tool, keyboard shortcut is the letter N. This is gonna sew one segment to another segment. What is a segment? Do you know the answer to that? A segment is the line in between any two dots. So see how it only selects one line at a time? So if you wanted to sew the armhole, it's not selecting all of the multiple segments in this armhole. So it can only do one segment at a time, really is the gist to start off with it. So this tool, I would say, works great for our shoulder seam because we have, you know, both of them are just one segment. So pretty easy. You would just click one time. Click and click. Now, do you notice, I didn't click yet. I'm still kind of just moving my mouse. Do you notice this little notch, how I can move it? This is telling the person at the sewing machine, like how to line up these two pattern pieces. So like, for example, should it line up the start of the neck to the start of this neck and sew towards the armhole? Or should it flip it and pull this armhole and line it up to this neck and sew them? Does that make sense? Like, so it can kind of sew backwards seams. So if you ever make a mistake, you can always right click and say reverse stitch. You'll see if it goes wrong. Like here, you can actually see up on the 3D model. So here is how I do want it sewn, right? All the stitches are straight. Imagine that being loose thread and you just pull the thread tight and the fabric pieces go together. That's great. What if I had the notch the wrong way? It's gonna twist it and it's gonna look funky. So this is what you don't want to see, okay? And you can control it by the notches. So I'm just hovering over here. This looks good. So all I have to do is click one time, click. So when you're first learning the sewing tools, I would say beginners love the segment sewing tool because it's so easy. You just click on one side and yet click on the other seam and voila, it's sewn together. But you kind of get into trouble when you, like this side seam, we need to sew all these pieces to this guy. So if you have, you know, like there's so many ways to fix this. Like one, I could just clean up these points and get rid of them. That'd probably be a better practice. But we also have the other sewing tool here. It is called the free sewing tool. So its keyboard shortcut is the letter M. Okay, so this guy's a little bit different. Where the segment sewing tool, I just had to click one time and the whole segment was selected. With the free sewing, you have to click twice to select a segment. You have to click at the start of the segment and you also have to click at the end. So what's cool about that is that you can get multiple segments. You're basically telling the computer where to start sewing and where to finish. Where when you use a segment tool, you don't have the power to say where you start and finish because it's just gonna do the whole segment. So play around with the two, see if you can tell the difference, what I'm talking about. So I'm in the free sewing one. So to select one seam line, I have to click where I wanna start. So I'm gonna click on this point. So I just click one time. And then, so it's gonna sew all of this. See how it's selecting more than one segment? And it's gonna keep sewing it until I click of where to stop. So I'm gonna click right here. Click, okay. So that's gonna be my first seam. And I wanna sew it over to this guy. So again, you know, because I started at the top underneath the arm, I should start the same place on the other guy. And I'll click one time and I'm like, yeah, keep sewing, keep sewing, keep sewing. Okay. And then I would stop right here. Now I'm going to, before I didn't quite stop yet, I just wanted to view so you can see what's going on over here. So you can kind of see how the stitches would go. If I stopped here, yeah, it would just kind of gather them. Do you see this blue dot that popped up? That is a really cool tool of the sewing tool where it's telling you like, hey, your first seam was 14.504 inches. You probably want to sew another seam that's also 14.50. That's what that dot is. So that tells me like, hey, this is the same length. And usually it's nice to sew seams that are the same length. So that's a really cool tool. So I just clicked one time to kind of secure that. So that's free sewing. Free sewing, you just have a little bit more power. It's a couple extra clicks, but it's real handy. So I'm going to go ahead and do free sewing with armhole. I'm going to start up here. I clicked one time. I'm going to click down here. Ooh, now here's hard because I started at her shoulder. So when I sew it to the sleeve, I wouldn't want to start here because this is her underarm. I would get a twisted seam. Okay, so it's better if I, maybe I'll just hit delete and start over. Maybe I'll start at her underarm seam. So I'm going to click right here. I'm going to go up to the shoulder and click. That's my first seam. Now I'm gonna go to the underarm and click one time. There's my blue dot. Now was this, I think this sleeve might've been drafted to fit perfectly, but sometimes you wanna ease in a sleeve that's a little bit bigger in the bell. So sometimes you want to go past your first dot. Depends on your pattern. So in this case, I'm just gonna click at the first dot. Okay, there we go. And then now I can click here and kind of keep going. And then click over here. So that's the most simple way to kind of explain these tools, segment versus free sewing. There are some other choices you can do. So maybe I will delete. No, you know, I won't delete. I'll sew the waistband. Okay. Another example is, well, I have this waistband here. And I actually really want to sew, I want to sew part of the waistband to the front and the other part to the back, okay? You have another tool, because the ones I showed you so far, I was just sewing like one seam at a time, right? I was like here to here, here to here. But what if I wanted to just click this one once? And then say, okay, you're like, I want to sew you to two pieces. I want to sew you to you and you. So if you hold down under the tools, they have this thing. They call it M to N. So you get to select, you know, your first seam, which they call the letter M. And you could have one thing selected. You could have three different pattern pieces selected, however many parts you want sewn. And then you hit enter, and then you get to select the N. It's a little advanced. So if this is your first time using the sewing tool, this, you know, maybe come back to this later if you get a little practice, but I'll just go ahead and demonstrate it right now. And it's the same thing, whether you use segment or free sewing, both of them have this tool. Segment, you just click one time, you know, or free sewing, you click at the beginning, click the end. So in this demo, I'm gonna actually, I'm gonna do free sewing. Okay, so for my first seam, I'm gonna start with this point and I wanna sew all the way here. And that's it, I'm done. And I love how it has a little instructions by my cursor. It says press enter to complete M sewing. So M is like your first seam, seam number one. So I'm gonna hit enter. Now it says, okay, you can start telling the computer where you wanna sew this to. And they're gonna call that letter N. So I wanna sew it to you. I'm gonna click, but I'm not done. So that's why I'm not gonna press enter because I want there to be more on the N side, if you will. So I'm also gonna click here and then saying, oh, there's my blue dot if you want it to be a perfect fit, but I actually wanted to stretch this out. So I'm gonna go a little bit longer. Okay, so I could keep sewing it to more stuff if I wanted, but that's it, I'm actually done. So I can hit return or enter. Okay, and it's thinking about it. Cool, so now you can see the little stitch lines. I'm gonna hit the little edit tool. How it's going to sew it to both sides. So that's kind of a fun one. Another thing is too, if you don't like the M to N, you can hold shift to select multiple seams when you're doing just your regular free sewing tool or the segment sewing tool. Some students have done that too, but that might be a little bit too much information for today. All right, guys, go ahead and sew up your garments and let me know how it goes.